Do you know that America has 4 times the number of tornadoes as the rest of the world? This not only caused $229 million in damage in 2021 and $165.1 billion in 2022, but it also robbed the lives of hundreds of individuals. From the tri-state tornado that killed 695 people in 3.5 hours on March 18, 1925, to the most recent EF4 tornado that swept away many homes in Kyoto, Iowa, United States, in a site of such damage. But the question remains, why is it exclusive to the United States? America, located in the Northern Hemisphere's mid-latitudes, is the world's third largest country by land area. Along with the Mississippi River, it gives the country Tornado Alley from Texas to Dakota. This creates a vast number of open regions for tornadoes to form and travel without being disrupted by the structures in between. This explains why the United States, with an area of 3.8 million square miles, experiences 1,150-plus average tornadoes each year compared to Europe, with an area of 3.93 million square miles and an average of 250-plus tornadoes per year. Tornadoes form when warm and moist air masses clash with chilly and dry air currents. In a nutshell, the death ballet begins when hot air pockets emitted by agricultural vegetation in the Gulf of Mexico collide with icy air from the Rocky Mountains. Also, when the slow-moving warm breeze clashes with the cold air, it causes the breeze to rotate and tilt. This war in the skies occurs at different times in each zone. For example, if you live in Texas, Kansas, or Oklahoma, which are located in the southern plains with rolling hills and plateaus, the best time to encounter them is from May to early June. However, if you live in the northern plains, such as North Dakota, Iowa, Nebraska, or even Minnesota, this will happen from the beginning of June to the end of July. Although tornadoes may not always arrive on the same day, they do have a consistent afternoon to early evening arrival time. But it's not only the number of tornadoes that makes a difference in devastation. Consider Texas, which has 140 tornadoes per year on average, compared to Alabama, which experiences 42. Alabama now has 14 fatalities each year compared to Texas, which has 8 fatalities per year. So it all comes down to one factor, topography. It's not as if other countries don't confront similar challenges. Consider Bangladesh, which is subjected to humid air from the Bay of Bengal and frigid winds from the Himalayan mountains. Each year it brings the country 6 tornadoes on average. We agree that the world's deadliest tornado, which occurred in Bangladesh in 1989, killed 1,300 people. It also injured more than 12,000 people. Can you, however, call the number 6 bigger than 1,200? Let's not even get started on 2023. There are still 1,078 confirmed tornadoes that occurred and killed 75 persons. There are still a few months remaining in the year. Situations shown in the movie Twister do take place in reality at times. One morning you're sleeping blissfully, you hear the alarm and go underground, crossing your fingers that it's not the last day of your life. Of course, being caught in a 400 kilometer per hour wind is not fun at all. Now that we've shared the basic information about tornadoes and why they majorly form in America, allow us to share the actual picture of these catastrophes through the survivors' actual stories. Credit goes to NPR for making us able to share their pain. It was the deadliest single tornado since 1947, which was barely behind the catastrophic impact of St. Louis and tri-state tornadoes. On May 22, 2011, the sky began to fill with gray clouds. Then there were terrible thunderstorms, which made everyone's heart drop. Suddenly, hail and wind were causing a tornado. This typhoon blew away 2,000 buildings after initially touching down in Newton County, Missouri at 5:34 p.m. It placed 138 people on their deathbeds inside their own homes and offices. David Vanderhoeven, who told Todd Feedback his experience, said how he was driving quickly and was only a few blocks away from his home when he realized there were no houses. He stepped close by and heard his 13-month-old child's terrified scream and frantic cry. He tried his hardest to be the Superman that his child might have imagined, pushing his hand beneath the debris to lift and save him. The little voice saying, "Help!" broke David's heart. But when he couldn't lift the wreckage, he drove another 20 minutes to bring the ambulance. After 2.5 hours, the authorities cleared the debris, only to bring the shattered remains of his child and wife. Even if we ignore the damage of $2.8 billion to the nation, how can anyone recover from such psychological wounds? But this is the story of every person in the area. Even if there are new buildings in the same location, people like Ashley McDowady can pinpoint precise locations where people died and left heaps of crumpled, splintered rubble. In such cases, the pain never goes away. It always lingers in the heart. Another NPR testimony will make you live in the moment for a split second. Assume you're only cooking for your two children and spending quality time with your partner. Suddenly the roof falls off, the pipes begin to hiss, and the electricity wires begin to sparkle. It's like a scene from one of the deadliest movies. Tiffany Stout and Shane, on the other hand, lived this reality. When the roof began to collapse, her husband Shane sheltered his wife and kids with his hand, even though it was instantaneously dislocated. Even though it had been years, both of the children who witnessed this had numerous nightmares about the storm. But that isn't just one child's tragic story. Consider Allie Stout, who is practically whirling in circles in the tornado. She merely tried to pull herself out and lay down on the floor, hoping that would help. She's been a fantastic athlete after more than 10 years, yet every thunderclap still gives her shivers. Every storm causes her to go for a small handbag, which contains her childhood blanket, and Pooh Bear, who survived the night with her. The hardest part is that the time does not always cure the trauma we face. There will be no tears left, only a desperate desire to let out the scream we constantly hear inside our souls. Finally, thanks to the radar system and weather satellites, which aid in detecting and tracking storms in real time, it greatly aids in providing people with warning signals to be safe and leave the area instantly in the event of an emergency. Since the EF5 tornado that struck Moore, Oklahoma on May 20, 2013, the government has been more concerned about such issues. Let us share some of the National Center for Environmental Health's guidance. Begin by constructing a safe shelter into which you can immediately flee. Pack a bag with non-perishable food, water, medicine, a battery-powered TV or radio, and any item that can connect to the internet. Next, keep an eye on the sky condition, such as a green sky, heavy hail, or loud roaring sounds, since this will help you determine if a tornado is approaching. Although there are no safe places when it comes to tornadoes, make sure to stay away from the window. Perhaps just crawl beneath a heavy table and cover yourself with a blanket or mattress. Even a closet can be helpful. If you're caught in a car, instead of driving hastily, attempt to find a sturdy building and go there. If you can't find one, simply lie down on the ground face down, as seen in the most recent episode of Young Sheldon. Currently, the American government has built storm shelters and raised public awareness about house building techniques like hurricane clips, but more work is needed to rescue the population. Now that we've provided the true image of tornadoes, what do you think is the best way to save yourself if you ever come across one? Do share your views with us. See you in our next video.